Well, we're back. Second week in a row. A little bit of panic because we do understand there's a few internet problems around and we have a few problems with phones. Someone's phone has gone off as well in my house. But anyway, sorry about that. We have a few internet problems in the Carlow Kilkenny area, so we do hope everybody can stay with us tonight. And if we do drop the stream, we will renegotiate it as quick as we can. So that's exactly what we will do. Right, we have a big show on tonight. Some people said last week we were a little bit too long. That wasn't by design, it was just by accident because we had so much volume of people that were taking part. We tried to facilitate everybody. So tonight it will be 2 hours, possibly a little bit longer than 2 hours, but we got some fantastic acts. We have some brilliant surprises in store as well. And I'd just like to thank everybody for tuning in last week and for all the positive feedback, both in the media as well, in the Carlow Nationalists. I'd like to thank Suzanne Pender and in the national media, and also to my comrades in KCLR 96 FM, because we got great feedback. 7,000 people watched the show last Monday night. So let's hope the figures are good tonight for something that started out as a pastime for Greg Meinhardt and Hedgehog Productions and myself over the last few days. It's got legs. So we're back tonight. There's difficult times out there. We're all to stay at home. Lots of people at home tonight. So we do hope you enjoy the show no matter where you are, across Ireland, across the world, or wherever you are. Now, we did promise last week we'd do it for charity tonight. The plan was do it for Dan, but they've hit their target of 2 million. So congratulations to everybody that was involved and the ongoing ones that they're finishing off with that were organised. So tonight, it's a charity that's close to me and a charity I've been working with since 1989. Tonight, any donations, if you feel like giving one, it's for the Carlow Kilkenny Home Care Team who do fantastic work in both counties for palliative care. So there is a link on the BenFM page, so you can donate if you would like to on that, and you can read a little bit about the Carlow Kilkenny Home Care Team as well, with Mr. Wilson and his team and all the great fundraisers in the Carlow Kilkenny area. Okay, the show is bigger than Carlow Kilkenny. We're going all over the place tonight. We're going to several different counties. We're starting in County Laois. We've John Kelly then in Ballon in County Carlow. Martina and Brendan Rinn are in County Roscommon. Brendan is a 13-year-old outstanding young singer. He's on the show tonight. We'll be having 4 interviews on the show because people said, why don't you do it a bit like a TV show? Not all music and entertainment. Interview people. We'll be having a live interview with Pádraig Pádjamant from Newport County in Wales in a couple of minutes' time. We'll have Paul Hennessy, my brother, back tonight. Tomás Jackman, young man in Kilkenny, who's one of the success stories out of his COVID-19 pandemic. This man was through the mill in the last few weeks. He's singing on our show tonight. He has recovered. Louise Delaney is back by popular demand. We have Davy Russell, 2-time Grand National winning jockey, coming live to us on the show tonight. We'll have an interview with Davy. Dale Hennessy and Pat O'Gorman, the famous Strat from J.K. Avenue, great saxophone player. He'll be with Dale on the show. We have a famous magician coming live from South Africa, Liam Joubert. Don't miss Liam Joubert tonight. This man is unbelievable. He's young, he's at it 6 years, and he's at the centre of excellence for magic in South Africa. He's coming live to your screens on the BenFM show, Liam Joubert. Tracy Millay is back. Tracy from Kilkenny, representing Kilkenny, hence the Carlow Kilkenny Home Care Team. We've lots of representation from Kilkenny tonight. We have Ed Byrne, the Leinster rugby player, doing a live interview from his home in Dublin. Dale Bulger, young up-and-coming rising star here in Carlow Town, son of Jimmy, professional golfer in Kilkenny, and Lee, his mammy, who a lot of people know very, very well. So we'll be joining Dale later on. Lorraine Nolan is back from Kildare, Newbridge in County Kildare, to sing a song for us tonight. We will be speaking to Rhianna Jarrett in an interview. Republic of Ireland centre forward from Brighton and Hove Albion and former Wexford Utes player will be with us tonight as well. Matt Levy, famous country singer from Athboy in the County of Meath, joins us tonight on the show, as does Joe Clear, a young local man here based in Ballochmyler, just outside of Carlow in County Laois. He's an international star. He will be singing with us tonight. By popular demand and by his request, he rang from America and says, can we be part of it again? Pat Byrne and Samantha Delafave, they'll be later on in the show due to the time difference in Austin, Texas. So Pat and Samantha are coming back to us tonight. Mickey Joe Hart, I told you, we've got the world tonight. Mickey Joe Hart from Donegal is coming on the BenFM show tonight. Eurovision 2003, he all sang it. You can sing it tonight if Mickey sings it on the show tonight. Then we're going back to Kilkenny, and Davy Cashin from the Kilkennys will be doing a number for us as well, a man with strong links in Carlow, and certainly with the Kilkennys, singing all over the world. All right, I've got the fan on because it's a little bit warm at home tonight. The sun is shining. A lot of people might be out walking. A lot of you out there. A lot of grey-haired people out there too, I might add, when are the hairdressers and the barbers opening. We're going to start where we started last week, with thanks to Greg and Hedgehog. He's doing all the linking. I'll do all the talking. There won't be as much this week. It'll be all entertainment. We're going to start in Collection, where we started the last night, with Trish Hutton, Claire Dunn, and Yvonne Bolton. So, Trish, you should be there. Good evening, Collection.
Hi, Brendan. How are you? Thanks so much for having us back. We're delighted to be here on your second programme. The last one was an awful lot of fun. Really, it was. And loads of people. I can't believe how many people text me and sent me messages saying, you know, that they love the programme and all that. So well done, you and Greg. Some amount of work. It's brilliant. But we're City Rocks. We're delighted to be back. We're going to play you a tune today, maybe, instead of a song. So this is a lovely tune that we got from the playing of the great Kevin Burke. Wonderful, wonderful fiddle player. And he called this tune Paris Night. So, we're going to play this for you and see how it goes, okay? 1, 2, 3, 1.
Well done, Trish. Well done, girls. There you are when they're playing their little bit of Claire Dunn and Yvonne Bolton. Claire on the left and Yvonne Bolton. So well done. They did a great job there for us last week and starting off the show tonight. Right, well, the sun is shining on Collection still. The sun is shining across Carlow, Kilkenny and across the Emerald Isle. It'll be bright till about 20 past nine. So we're relatively early enough. Might be clashing with the soaps. But if you missed out on the start, there is a few internet problems and Wi-Fi problems in the area. So if we do drop the stream, we will renegotiate and we'll be up and running again. In saying that, we're going to Ballon in the county of Carlow, a young man that's very well known to you all, a very proud Carlovian, sings with Roisin Dove. He's been singing his lifetime. I know him quite a while. A very proud Carlow man indeed. John Kelly, are you in Ballon? Good evening, John.
Hi, Brendan. How are things? Great to hear from you. I hope you're keeping well. I was delighted to get the call to come on the Ben FM internet show, and it's great to be here with such an illustrious lineup of people. I'm really happy to be here. Thanks very much. So I'm going to go straight into a song now. This is probably my favourite song, written about our great old county, Carlow, written by PJ McCall, and it's called Follow Me Up to Carlow. So everybody at home might sing along. If McKay, you roll your face, putting all over the old disgrace, the Black Fitzwilliam storm your place and draw you to the burn. Grace and victory was sure, and soon the fire and heat secure, until he met at Glenmalure with Fate McKilborn. And course and swear, Lord Kildare, Fate will do what Fate will dare. Now Fitzwilliam, have a care, father needs your star low. Up with halberd, down with sword, on we go for by the Lord. Fate McHugh is given the word, follow me up the Carlo. See the swords of Glenmalure flashing all o'er the English fields, see all the children of the Gael beneath the Burns banners. Rooster of a fighting stock, would you let a Saxon cock crow upon an Irish rock, play up in each of manners? And course and swear, Lord Kildare, Fate will do what Fate will dare. Now Fitzwilliam, have a care, fallen is your star, Lord. Up with halberd, down with sword, on a way go for by the Lord. Deep with you is given the word, follow me up the Carlo. The sacred come to come o'er, there flows a stream of Saxon gore. Oh, great is Ory, oh, go more, sending the loons to Hades. White is gone, grey is dead, now for Black was Fitzwilliam's head. We send it over to the Red Queen, Eliza and her ladies. And course and swear, Lord Kildare, people do what people dare. Now Fitzwilliam, have a care, fallen is your star, Lord. Up with halberd, down with sword, on the way go for by the Lord. Deep with you is in the word, follow me up the Carlo. Everybody out there enjoyed that song. Before I go, I'd just like to say thanks to everybody who tune in on the Thursday night to see my little show on Facebook. Your appreciation and good wishes have really bowled me over, and I'm really enjoying doing it. So keep the old requests coming in on that. So thanks, Brendan, for the call tonight. And can I send best wishes to all my family and friends in Carlo and all the surrounding countries and all over the world. Just ask people to keep safe, keep home, and and we'll all get out of this together. Don't worry. So, peace, everybody. Slán leat go léir, agus tuairim ar go léir.
Gur maith agat, John. Thanks very much there, John, in Ballon in the county of Carlow. So we started in Laois, or into Carlow, and we'll be heading to Roscommon in a minute. But Stephen O'Connor is a man from that neck of the woods, and he's watching us in Canada at the moment. And we did a count last week, we counted back, I think we'd over 37 different countries tuned into the BenFM show, but that is because of the Irish diaspora all over the world looking into the connections that everybody has. And to be fair to everybody entertaining on the show last week and tonight, everyone is doing this with their free time. Nobody gets anything for this. We've given our time. Greg and I set out to do this just to pass the time, because we're all out of business in relation to the television job and all of that. So you all know that everybody's in the same boat, so there's not a lot happening out there. But just turning to the scrolls for a moment, Lillian Houlihan is up on the top of the hill there as well. Cora Long is in South Kilkenny. Good evening, Cora. Mentioning Kilkenny, we're doing it tonight for the Carlo Kilkenny home care team. So if you want to make a donation, it's on the scroll underneath and it's on the BenFM TV page. Now, we set a target over the next 2 weeks for 5,000 for the Carlo Kilkenny home care team. So hopefully we can get there. If we don't, we're giving it a rattle anyway. So if you have a spare few bob to spare and you want to donate it, it's a fantastic charity. Mr. Wilson and all his team doing a terrific job, as they have been doing since 1989. Oliver Johnson, good man, he's enjoying it as well. And Sharon O'Byrne and Padraig Carter is also watching there as well. Lacking pitch and putt. Pitch and putt must be stopped. But anyway, I said we started in Laois, we went to Ballon in Carlo. We're now going to Arigna, a lovely part of County Roscommon, and a young man who has seen once before, he's 13 years of age now, is going to sing a song for us with his mammy Martina on the keyboard. So it's Martina and Brendan Wrynn, and they're in County Roscommon, and they should be there. Good evening, Martina.
Hi, Brendan. Thanks for having us on the show. I hope you're all enjoying it. Tonight, Brendan is going to sing a Rolling Stones song called Wild Horses.
It's easy to do.
Well, what about that for a voice? Brendan Wrynn in Erignan County, Roscommon, a man with a brilliant future as well. He goes to Evolution Stage School in Longford as well. He was recommended to me by my brother Paul, who's also not a bad singer. I'll hear him fairly soon as well. Good evening to Seamus Farrell as well, a man I started my life out with on the bottom floor in the Sugar Company. He's watching in tonight as well. How are you, Seamus? And to everybody watching tonight, lots of people texting in and different things coming in. Don't forget, we are here for the Carlow Kilkenny Home Care Team. The link is on the page and you'll see it on the scroll on the bottom. So it is impossible to get to everybody. We got 1,600 texts the last time, but anyway, we're delighted with that because there's great feedback. And we want everybody to stay at home, obey the rules for the next few days and the weeks, whatever happens. And if we do it together, we'll all be out of it together quicker than we think. So no matter how good the weather is, bank holiday weekend, the message is stay at home. Right, one man that's not at home tonight, he's across the water and he's joining me on the phone now for a chat, and that's a great Carlovian, Padraig Amond. And people did say we need a few interviews on this show, Brendan. Well, we've got them and we have them live for you tonight. Padraig is in Wales. As you know, he's a striker with Newport County. He's a professional soccer player, 15 years, and he's there. Padraig, good evening, and how is things in Wales this evening?
Thanks for very much for having me, first of all, Brendan. Hope all is well. It's unusual at the minute. Obviously, we don't know really what's happening at the moment. We're just going off as much government advice as we can get, and trying to train ourselves and keep ourselves going at the time being. But I suppose no one really knows when we're going to be back. But there's more important things in life at the minute. People dying every day, and you know, it's very sad to see the numbers every day, especially over here. You know, there's I think 800, 900 people dying a day. So I suppose getting back to sport is probably very low on the priority of a lot of people. I think just normality in people's lives is what they really want to get back to. And, you know, as long as it takes, it takes.
And Padraig, in the current climate now, I know a lot of people are becoming great painters and in their houses because we're all on stand down and lockdown and the restrictions and cutting grass and gardening and chipping a few golf balls. I did see you on social media a few weeks back. You were chipping golf balls in the back garden. Is there any golf in Wales in the current climate, or are the golf courses closed like they are here in Ireland?
Everything is closed over here again at the minute. We're allowed out for exercise for an hour a day. So it's just, you know, it's just one of those things that you just have to follow the rules, and the longer you follow the rules for, the quicker I suppose we'll be all back to normality, hopefully, because, you know, everyone is missing everything. They're missing just the simple things in life of going to see friends and family, and this, look, it's just really sad what's happening at the minute. But at the same time, look, touch wood, everything's been all right.
Padraig, you've had a great innings. You know, I remember back, it's only a few years, when you were a young kid, minor, playing for Carlow and Croke Park in the Leinster final. Not many Carlow people got to play in Leinster finals. That was a huge day for you, a huge day for Carlow. But then the soccer career kicked off and Sligo Rovers comes to mind, Shamrock Rovers, Paco de Fierro. Your early days with St. Patrick's, Boys AFC here in Carlow, Shamrock Rovers, underage structure, and you graduated up along the ladder. Then there's Grimsby, all the clubs you've played with in England. You've had a tremendous innings.
Yeah, look, I've loved every minute of it. It was my dream when I was, as long as I can remember anyway, I'd say my man Dal will tell you the exact same. I've always said I wanted to be a footballer type thing, and I've been lucky enough to kind of get lucky breaks along the way. Obviously, there's a lot of hard work involved in it, and, you know, I suppose being away from friends and family is kind of the norm for me, you know, at this stage, being away so long. But I've loved every minute of it. I think the last few years have just kind of everything took off into a different way completely with the FA Cup and the publicity kind of that came along with that, which was brilliant. You know, and it just, you know, it proved that I picked the right path to come along in my journey and in my career anyway. And it was a hard journey, and, you know, there were times probably when it was like, you know, is it worth it type thing. But I'll be honest with you, I really, that was more so from everyone else point of view, but I've loved every second of it. I wouldn't change any of it, really, to be honest with you. Maybe a few more trophies would be nicer, but what can you have? Look, it's been professional for nearly 15 years now. 14, 15 years. Obviously, some of that was kept under wraps with the hurling at the time. We were keeping everything kind of as quiet as possible. But yeah, it's been brilliant. I've loved it.
Patrick, in your 15 years as a professional soccer player, what is your best memory? You know, recently you've played against Manchester City, Leicester City in the FA Cup, some of the big clubs, Ronaldo in Dublin a couple of years back. You know, you've played against some of the best. What's the best memory?
I suppose, although a cap never materialised, being called into the Irish in the provisional squad that time, that was, that kind of topped off kind of the FA Cup run, if that makes sense. Yeah, probably one of my biggest regrets is probably not enjoying the Man City goal a little bit more at the time, because I firmly believed we were going to get a second goal, and it was so close. But looking back on it now, I go back and I don't really celebrate that goal, and that's the competitive side of me where I'm thinking, yeah, we can get another goal, where realistically 40 seconds later it was over, and then I thought, you know what, I should have just milked that minute and a half, and maybe they wouldn't have scored as quick again, and would have given us a better chance of getting on. But I suppose probably the Irish kind of call up at the time, and our winning at Wembley with Grimsby, I suppose every you grow, you know, you've been the same. You're watching the old FA Cup finals and all that, and everyone kind of wanted to play at Wembley and win a trophy and walk up those steps at Wembley. Obviously, it was the older Wembley we would have been watching and stuff like that. But it's a feeling I don't think you can beat. And unfortunately, I've lost a couple of times at Wembley, and that's the worst feeling. That's a horrible feeling. So being on the other side of it, it's a lot better. So probably the Wembley win, maybe, at Grimsby.
And part of, you have set up life in Newport. You've really settled in there over the last number of years. You're married now to a Carlo girl, I might add. And you're there, and everybody across the world, there's Carlo people all over the world and lots of Irish people. Everybody knows who Podge Amond is. And as the commentators in England say, Amond or whatever. But, you know, have you a message for all those people and all the people at home? Because I know you keep close contact with all that happens.
Yeah, look, it's brilliant. I think anywhere you go in the world, if you meet someone from Carlo, they'll always welcome you, you know, and always give you give you all the little tips and the local tips that you want. Look, I love being from Carlo. I love going back home, watching sports, watching my brothers play, whatever sport it is, and just watching Carlo play as well. And that's brilliant. And look, just, I suppose if there's one thing you kind of say is just follow the advice that what the professor or what the experts are giving us, because the more we fight it, the longer we're going to be away from sport, and the more people are going to be dying. And, you know, I think people just want normality back in life, want, like I said, to be able to go hug parents, brothers, sisters, nieces, nephews, whatever, my grandparents, stuff like that. So people are missing out on that. So just follow the government advice, and fingers crossed it won't be too much longer before we come out the other side of this.
So, Patrick, thank you very much for joining us tonight on the BenFM Show. We're all very proud of your great career, and we're really delighted that you've joined us here on the BenFM Show tonight in a time that we are trying to keep everything upbeat. And we'd like to thank you for your time tonight, and best wishes to you and your family in Wales, and in particular, all your family back home here on the Emerald Isle. So thanks for being with us, Pete.
Thanks very much, Brendan.
Well, there we are, Patrick Amond, comments coming in, one of Carlo's finest sportsmen, and that it is, indeed he is, and a gentleman at that. So we salute to Pat and Patty out there in the Railock as well, and all his family and all his brothers. It's a team of men there as well, but he's got a great connection back with the Carlo GA as well. His late grandfather, Liam Quigley, was an outstanding sportsman with Carlo, and that's his granddad on his mammy's side as well. So we salute all the Quigleys as well tonight. Thanks for all the comments. I'm starting to see that I have aunts and uncles on social media that didn't even know what an iPad was 3 weeks ago. My mother's on Instagram, Crafty Nanny Claire, if you want to add her. Now I see Auntie Cack is on Facebook. That's enough. You won't have to look at the news anymore now, lads. Cackle. Hiya, Cack. There you go. But speaking of outstanding sportsmen, Brian Corden was very helpful to me this evening, and to Greg down at Hedgehog. We had a few little problems, and Brian was on the ball, and he had a chat with us. And you might remember the name Corden. Well, there is a picture of Andrew Corden. That's Andrew, and sadly we lost Andrew many years ago, but he would have celebrated his 42nd birthday 42nd birthday on the 25th, 2 days ago. So we just thought we'd remember Andrew tonight. We have his shirt here, the number 3 shirt that he wore at fullback for Carlow as well. So in good times and bad times, we remember the great sports people and a man that I had the pleasure of broadcasting games with as well. One that comes to mind is Nemo Rangers and O'Hanrahan's in the All-Ireland semi-final of 2000 down in Clonmel. So we remember Andrew and all our faithfully departed people tonight as well. So thanks to Padraig there. Lots more sports personalities coming up. And don't forget the magic man from South Africa coming up, Liam Joubert, in the not-too-distant future on the programme. We have Mickey Joe Hart coming up. We have Davy Cashett. We have lots and lots of great entertainers. But the next man I know well, he was with us last week. He's based in Longford at the moment. He really needs no introduction, but he's in Longford again tonight, and he's joining us, and that's my brother, Paul Hennessy. He's doing his own shows at the moment, and they're going very, very well for him, and he raised a lot of money for charity last Sunday night week on his show, live from his home in Longford. So I couldn't have a show and not bring my brother back on, or I'd be in trouble. Paul, you should be in Longford. Good evening.
Well, Brendan, how's things? Great to be back on the show with yourself and Greg. Well done last week. It was an amazing show, or 2 weeks ago, whatever it was amazing. Well done to everyone who was on it. It was a great night. I hope everyone's enjoying tonight as much. I feel a bit left out, though, with all the jerseys, so I have my Leeds one here to keep me company. All right, this is Over the Rainbow. I heard of once in a lullaby. Somewhere over the rainbow, sky. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me. Where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops, that's where I'll wake and rub my eyes, and in that land beyond the skies, you'll find me. I'll be a laughing daffodil and leave the silly cares that fill my mind. Happy little blue. let's fly beyond the rainbow. Why, oh, why can't
Okay, there we are. Thanks very much, Paul. I was wondering where my shirt went, a stripy shirt. Now I know it's in Longford, but he did a fine performance. He got lots of great compliments coming in there about the great voice, but he's singing quite well a long number of years. I didn't point out he's my older brother, all right? So there you are. But thanks to Paul. He's been very helpful over the last 2 weeks as well. He's given us a dig out with the likes of Charlie McGettigan and young Brendan Wren a few moments ago, and Emma Reynolds and Ashley Farrell up in the Midlands. But we're nearly in every county tonight. We're going from Longford to Kilkenny. This man is a great friend of mine. He's a great friend of the people of Kilkenny and around, and made no secret of the fact that he has recovered from COVID-19 and he was in a bad way 3 weeks ago. This is his first live appearance since he was sick. He battled through. He's there. He's in Kilkenny and he's a very good man to fundraise as well. He was excellent in Shillelagh when we raised money, 10,000 for the Father Ray Foundation orphanage back in November of last year and in 2018. Thomas Jackman, good evening, Kilkenny.
Thank you very much, Brendan. Yeah, I've been through the mill there for the last couple of weeks. But listening to KCLR and your show there the last couple of weeks was fantastic. One of my highlights was Tracy Millay and Ruby. What fantastic singers. And big shoes to fill this week. But I'm going to give it a go. And I'm going to dedicate this song to my mother-in-law, Mary Cotton, who's in Castlecomer at the moment recovering. And it's a song called The Boston Rose. So here it goes.
The tourists have all gone, and the children, they have all come back to school. My life is as it was before. I work 8 hours a day, but the company's still making all the rules. There's a girl in Massachusetts, Sarah Boston town, she said, and her lovely face is with me all the day. But I met her down in Old Tree, golden hair upon her head. I took her heart and she stole mine away. So goodbye, my Boston beauty. Farewell, my Boston Rose. I'll wait for you, I'll think of you, the track to you I'll pose. So goodbye, my Boston beauty. Farewell, my Boston Rose. I wish that you were here, but I know that's the way life goes. There's a song we sang also in the bars of Dublin town. I can hear it on the factory radio, and the feelings I remember when I hear that simple tune makes me wonder if it ever happened so. For we laughed and loved together till the summer days were gone, and you had to fly across the ocean wide. So goodbye, my Boston beauty, until we meet again, and I keep the fire burning deep inside. So goodbye, my Boston beauty. Farewell, my Boston rose. I'll wait for you, I'll think of you, the tread to you I'll pose. So goodbye, my Boston beauty. Farewell, my Boston rose. I wish that you were here, but I know that's the way life goes. And sometimes when I'm dreaming, my friends have gathered round, and just for fun, someone brings up your name. Well, I laugh there with the rest of them, for I can't hear a sound. I love you, but to them it's all the same. And nights when I'm alone, love, you come into me mind, and visions flash upon my inward eye. Well, they look out at the stars above, they leave this world behind, and it's hard to you as I go sailing by. So goodbye, my Boston beauty, farewell, my Boston woes. I'll wait for you, I'll think of you, the tread to you I'll pose. So goodbye, my Boston beauty, farewell, my Boston woes. I wish that you were here, but I know that's the way life goes. I wish that you were here, so farewell, my Boston Rose.
There you go, lovely song there called The Boston Rose, written by Liam Riley. And just before I go, Brendan, I would like to thank, say a huge thank you to all my family and friends and my supporters who sent me loads of prayers and good wishes while I was in hospital. And especially huge thanks to everyone in St. Luke's Hospital, all the staff out there who looked after me really, really well. And folks, stay safe and stay at home. And hopefully when it's all over, I'll see you at some of my gigs. So back to you, Brendan.
Yeah, thanks very much, Tomás. You're a gentleman, and thank you very much. Tomás Jackman there in Kilkenny. And as I said, he made no secret of the fact he spoke live on KCLR to Eamonn Vrenan and to Sue Nunn just a fortnight ago. And that is Tomás's first gig since he recovered from COVID. And to say that man was on oxygen over 3 weeks ago, there is positivity in the situation, so it's not all doom and gloom. So a credit to him and his family for appearing with us tonight on the BenFM show. Now, mentioning Kilkenny, don't forget, there's a link on the scroll, it's on the page. We are donating tonight to the Carlow Kilkenny Home Care team. And before we go to our next guest, I just want to thank John Byrne in Boston, Massachusetts. He heard Tomás singing, and he was the first man to donate, and he made no secret of the fact John has thrown 100 quid into the kitty for there as well. So thank you very much, John. Former Carlow great and Navan Michael hurler as well. So back to Carlow from Kilkenny. Thanks, John, and from the Boston Rose. We're going to Carlow, young lady we had last week from a family of terrific singers and a fine singer, her brother called Michael, who I believe has signed up for a few gigs as well. She's just down the road from my home place here in Pollerton. Good evening, Louise Delaney.
Hi, Brendan. Hi, everyone. I hope you're having a great night. Thanks a million, Brendan, for asking me to be part of the show once again. Tonight I'm going to sing a song, and I'd like to dedicate it to my ma and my dad.
When the rain is going
Thanks, Louise. She's not a woman to talk. She's a little bit shy away from singing, so she bailed out quick last week and quick this week as well. I said, stay with me now for a few minutes. No, I won't. So there we are. Thanks to Louise, and we wish all her family the very, very best of luck as well. Now, I did say we were going to have little short interviews and a few minute long interviews with Padraig Hammond earlier on, and because I'm involved in sports, there's lots of great sports people, you know, but I got to thank my sister and my brother-in-law, Roberto and Anne in Yall, because they're very good friends with Jerry Russell, and Jerry is the father of world famous national hunt jockey Davy Russell, and I got a text straight away to remind me when I mentioned him at the top of the programme that he won the Grand National twice, that he also won the Gold Cup. He won nearly every big race that can be won. So I am delighted to be joined on the line and on the show live from East Cork, a beautiful part of the world, y'all, in the county of Cork, by double Grand National hunt jockey Davy Russell. Good evening, Avi.
How are you going? All good?
Not too bad. And Davy, how is Davy Russell filling in his time at the moment? Because jockeys are normally up early in the morning riding out in different stables, and then you're off racing, and it's more or less a 7-day-a-week job and that. Like, how are you putting in your time at the moment?
We're busy, to be honest, on the farm. There's a lot of mares falling and mares to be put back in foals. So, to be honest, it's been incredibly busy, and we're trying to do jobs maybe that we mightn't have always got around to, the ones that you're always looking at every day and passing by, you're trying to get them done. But five kids, and you know, it's all going now. I don't get much time to myself.
Five kids is a big undertaking, Davy. And I do know, because someone hinted to me a while back as well, your wife was a good, great international sports star as well.
Yeah, she was quite accomplished. She was a very good pole vaulter.
Yeah, national champion. Very, very good. Where did you meet, Davy?
We met walking down the street about 1 o'clock in the morning outside the Hole in the Wall in Galway on the night.
Galway.
Yeah, I had no ride on the Tuesday, so I was out Monday night, and there was a couple of Limerick hurlers were after getting knocked out of the championship, and there was one of the lads was hiring, so they were having a bit of a send off for him, and so we met up, and we met herself and a friend of hers, and that was the end of that. Then that was the end of my gallivanting after that.
Davy, looking back at your career, you have a long and distinguished career. I mean, as a young guy, point-to-point champion, two or three occasions. And then you went across the water, worked for Ferdy Murphy, and you worked for a host of other trainers. Came back home, Jigginstown number one. All the great horses you've rode, all the brilliant winners and the big tracks, the big meetings, then the Cheltenhams, the Aintree. And when I speak of Aintree, Tiger Roll, how special is this horse? Two Grand Nationals back to back, and you became the first jockey since Graham Fletcher on Red Rum, I think, to break that record, or not break it, equal that record.
He's very special. He's a huge part of my career, and he's a huge part of all our lives. Now, at this stage, really, you know, there's not too many conversations going on about horse racing without, and he's not mentioned in it. So it's just, I'm just very pleased to have been a small part of his career, and he of mine. He's a huge part of mine now.
And Davy, looking at when Tiger Roll won the Grand National and came back up to Summerhill and County Meath, up to Gardens area, and then you brought Tiger Roll to y'all, all the talk in the national media was this could be the end for Tiger Roll, and the O'Learys more or less said that. But then the talk was, as the year went on, he was going to take part in the Grand National. Now it hasn't happened. But do you believe Tiger Roll still will have the ability come 2021 for the Aintree Grand National?
Yeah, the plan is, I think, to give it a go anyway. I'm fairly sure that the horse will tell Gordon and the lads, you know, that know him the best, whether it's on or not. So Jigginstown and Eddie and Michael and Anita, they're all happy enough to give him a shot at trying to create history, you know. It's different now, I suppose, when it was going to be three in a row, but he'll get another chance at it, hopefully.
You came fourth in the virtual one, I see.
Yeah, I tell you one thing now, I nearly give back the riding fee.
And Davy, with all the great work you've done, another brilliant win was the French Gold Cup. I think they call it the Paris de Cup or whatever. It was a big, big race in 2019. And, you know, we hear a lot about racing in Ireland and England, but you go over to France and you ride in the biggest race in France and you win it. I mean, that's a brilliant milestone on your career as well.
It was a huge part of it now, and to be honest, it was very special. It was just came on, you know, there was no real thought or anything put into it. It was a spare ride, came up, and I was asked to go over, and I always wanted to ride in it because the fences over there are quite unique, and they're massive, big, massive fences over there. And I just felt it would be nice to have a go at it and say I'd done it. He was kind of maybe fourth or fifth favourite, but his training was very confident. And it really was a highlight, one of the big highlights of my career, to go and over there and compete in it. And then to win it was extra special, you know. He's a very talented horse, and he's trained by a very good lady trainer over there. She's a pleasure to deal with. And I've ridden quite a number of times since, unsuccessfully. He's been placed and things, but I think he's going to have another crack at it. And they've been on there that if racing resumes in May, that he's likely to run, I think, on the 11th of May. I think they've asked me, can I get over there for the 11th to ride him again? So, but yeah, definitely was a big something that I really, really, really enjoyed, and I felt quite proud of. I'm not quite sure if I'm the only Irish-based rider to win it, but one of them.
So, David, before we let you go tonight, I know you're a big sports fan other than horse racing, and you're big into the GN. I'm sure you'd like to see Cork winning in All-Ireland, let it be football or hurling, but I know hurling is your number one, being a man from East Cork, where it's very strong. But are you still riding out at the moment, or is that all stopped as well?
No, riding out, but it's all... Gardens is just a bit too far away. The lads around me then are kind of, you know, all steadied up, so I've no riding out. But to be honest, I'm very, very busy, and fitness is still ready to rock and roll when they give us the go ahead. So at my age, I can't really leave my fitness go too much. My weight is a huge issue as well, so I can't leave my weight go either. So just
off them chips down there, and y'all.
Yeah, the best of chips in
Roma Grill down in Yall. Well, Davey, just before we go, have you a message for all the people out there looking in tonight? Because you're very well known and world famous. The people would probably like to hear something nice from Davey Russell tonight.
Yeah, I suppose the most important thing is to keep active, keep your body and your mind active, whether it's around the garden. But you need to get out of bed. You need to get out of bed and have some bit of normality. If your garden isn't gleaming at this point, I think you should go out and get at it and be active. I think it's very, very important. I think we have to stay active in our minds and in our bodies and keep some bit of normality. I know it's all great and well that you get an extra hour or two in bed, but I don't think it's going to benefit you in the long run. I think people need to get up and be active and get in some way normal. You know what I mean? And I think then, as we say, same as us, when the flag drops for us all to go back and slowly get back into things, we'll be ready to go, you know.
Okay, Davey, well, thank you very much for joining us from your home in Yall in County Cork this evening, and we wish you well going forward, and we look forward to seeing you back in the saddle and hopefully see you in Aintree next year as well on Tiger Roll, and hopefully put the three in a row together in that Grand National. But again, Davey Russell, thank you very much.
You don't want me to sing a song, or?
Yeah, you can if you want. Do you sing, Davey?
We are busy,
and we'll keep the show moving. There's lots of messages coming in. Evia and Zinders are watching. They're just in out of the garden, so I hope the garden is looking well, Evia and Zinders, and lots of painting done, as Davey said, if it's not done by now. Catron Healy and all the gang are watching in Kilkenny, and good evening, Emma Timmins as well. Olive is very happy with her sister Louise. She did a cracking job indeed, and she certainly did a great job. We're coming back local because we're coming back to Carlow Town, and one of these men is in Tinryland, so we managed to link up that the two of them are coming in together. And the two men I mentioned are Dale Hennessy and Pat O'Gorman. Pat is better known as Strat, a former member of the Army Band of the Curragh Command, brilliant saxophonist. We had Berishelli last week playing Dance Monkey, but Pat is joining us with Dale Hennessy this evening. So good evening, lads. I had the pleasure of touring Ireland with you with All the Rose of Tralee, which is not on this year, unfortunately. But good evening, lads, and it's good to see you doing a gig on the television tonight with BenFM. What more can I say, Strat and Dale?
Thanks for inviting us to perform tonight on BenFM. We saw last week's show and it was an absolute success. So congratulations to everybody involved. Myself and Strat are going to play a couple of songs for you, and we dedicate these to anybody at home and anybody abroad that's tuned in. Thank you.
Hey Brennan, Strat here. Great show last week. We're going to dedicate these tunes to anyone on the front line working hard. very hard job, and I hope you enjoyed them.
Here we go.
Enjoyed that. Best of luck with the show. Stay safe.
Thanks, Brendan.
All right, lads. Thanks very much. There you are, Dale and Pat. It's not easy back to communicate, but there we are. Baker Street, Pat O'Gorman, one of the finest saxophonists in the country, and Dale doing a great job as well. I said I had thousands of cousins, but I couldn't put them all on, so we might get one or two more on next week as well, along with other people from right around the country. Now, we did have a South African person last week, Keith Hutchinson, based in Bristol, playing the keyboard, but I did tell you we had lots of surprises on tonight's show, and we're going live now. A great friend of Greg Meinhardt's family. Greg is the man that's driving proceedings with Hedgehog Productions in Carlow tonight. This young man went to school with Greg's son, Richard, and he is in the School of Magic in South Africa. Cape Town is renowned for being one of the most famous places in the world for learning to do magic. This young man is doing it for 6 years, and he's gladly joining us on the show today, and he was only too glad to come onto the show today and broadcast his little bit of magic on the BenFM show here on the Emerald Isle. So they're on the same timeline, longitude, in Cape Town, South Africa. So good evening, Liam Joubert.
Hello, Brendan. It's so lovely to be here to joining you guys all today. It's lovely joining you from South Africa, from the comfort of my own home. It's the first ever show I'm doing from my own house. So thank you very much for the wonderful opportunity. I absolutely love the show you guys are putting on.
Thanks.
And everything that you guys are doing. So I'm glad that I can add a little bit of magic to this. I think first things first, let's give you a little bit of a break, hey, Brendan? We'll make you disappear. Just like that. Now that it's just us, without Brendan, I want to show you guys some magic. Now, I'm primarily a close-up magic performer. That means I use things like this, decks of cards or coins or anything like that. But I think today I'm going to use a deck of cards. Let's see if we can try something with this. We don't need that anymore. So what we're going to do is we're going to use a deck of cards, a blue standard bicycle deck of cards. These are actually bicycle seconds. They're just a little bit cheaper than the normal, if you will, rider-back deck of cards. They're sort of like the offcuts. Doesn't matter anyway. So what I want you to do is, you're not here. Normally what I would do is I would get the spectator to reach in and they would choose a card. But obviously because we can't do that, we're going to do it a little bit differently. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the deck just like this, and I hope you guys can also see. And I'm just sort of going to stop roughly, let's say, shall we go one more? Shall we not go one more? Let's go one more, sure. One more, just like that. And we'll stop here, not the 4 o'clock. Let's grab this one here, the two of diamonds, right? I hope you guys can see everything there. The two of diamonds. Let's do this, actually. We leave it somewhere face down in the middle of the deck, just over there. And we're gonna do this, because now, obviously, I can find it quite easily if I just leave it there. But if I take the top half of the deck and I shuffle it into the bottom half of the deck after turning it over, just like this, right, what we should get is half the face-up cards going into the face-down cards, just sort of like that. You can see it just over there. Right, we'll shuffle those all the way in, just like that. So, if you have a little bit of a look here, we've got some cards face up, and we've got some cards face down, right? Again, some cards face up, some cards face down, you get it. What we're going to do, though, is we're going to try to remember that we're going to focus on that two of diamonds. Now, we're going to try to take all the cards in the deck, right? All those cards that are face down, we're going to try to turn them over in the deck, make them face up, except for that one two of diamonds. All right, let's see if we can get this right. Just with a snap of the fingers. Just like that. Shall we have a look? Check it out. I'll show you. If we go through like this, all the cards are face up, except this one card here in the middle of the deck. If you have a look, this one card is the two of diamonds. Right? But actually, let me break one of the rules of magic, one of the biggest rules of magic. Actually, I'm going to show you how I do this. If you have a look, what I've got is on the back of the two of diamonds is I put a little mark. I don't know if you can see it there. It's a little red mark just in the corner. It doesn't matter if you can't see it. I'm going to show you on the rest of the cards now. So if you have a look, we'll leave the two of diamonds at the bottom of the deck. Let me know if you can see it on that one. All right, or this one, or all of those. You can see the red mark on that one, right? Yeah? And that. You can see the red mark on all of them now, obviously, except that one two of diamonds. All right, let me show you one more time. You got the two of diamonds, the blue one, right? And then the rest of the deck, which is all red. All right, even seven of spades. But check this out, because I now can't use this deck, obviously, because the two of diamonds is blue and the rest of the deck is red. We're going to try something. With this two of diamonds, actually, let's try this. Two of diamonds, what we'll do is we'll leave it, actually, normally what I would do is I would use my magic wand, but I'm not sure where that is now. Let's try this. Just like that. We get a red two of diamonds just over there. So now I have an entirely red deck of cards that I can use for my next show, which is great because hopefully we'll be doing more of these online shows. But yes. I hope you guys have all enjoyed that, and I mean, I've had a wonderful time. It's really, really strange performing online without having an actual crowd around you to be able to like look at and perform for. But this has been so much fun. First things first, I think we need to bring Brendan back. Thank you very much for letting me steal a little bit of the spotlight. You guys have been absolutely amazing. I hope you have a wonderful evening, and I will hopefully see you in my next online show. Have a wonderful evening, guys. Enjoy it. See you soon, Brendan. Thank you very much.
Oh, man, Liam. He's unbelievable, and I know we're in lockdown and no one can travel anywhere, but if anybody is traveling to South Africa in the next few years when we can, make sure you go see him, because he does street markets entertainment in Johannesburg and in Cape Town, but he's in the famous School of Magic in Cape Town as well. Now, there's hundreds and hundreds of people texting in here at the moment. I wrote down a few of them there when Liam is on. Now, I have to say hello to Jenny Doyle, and we have to play a request for her Nanny Claire McDonald in Rossmore View and Grey Cullen from Daniel and Ruby. They miss going to see Nanny in the house and can't wait for the lockdown to be over. That comes in. Love to you, Nanny. All right, so that's Jenny Dial, and I think there's a connection there with Gary Dial and Ollie, Aron Kelly Basher. I think there's a connection there. Thanks to Angela for giving us that one as well. Now, I missed the request last week. Sophie Geraghty, are you there? She's from Kilmessan. Do you see Kilmessan back here? I was in Sophie's house when she was only three, and Sophie celebrates her 11th birthday recently. So happy birthday to Sophie and to her sister Aoife. I was at Aoife's christening, and to Mark and Anya and all the gang in Kilmessan there as well, to Ellie and Sharon and to Dosser and to Katie. They're all in Riverstown there as well. His cousin is singing later on, Matt Levy, Irish country singer. So good evening to Royal County and to all the Murphys up there as well. James and Dosser mentioned there as well. Aaron Mullins and Ruth O'Callaghan watching in Canada tonight. Elizabeth Montgomery is in St. Catharines. Seen your name on the list, Elizabeth. Your jersey is hanging on the back here. So thank you very much. Reggie Condren and Tina. Reggie is not giving out on Facebook tonight. He's enjoying the Ben FM show. Mary Lou. I can't sing Mary Lou for you tonight, Reggie, but thanks very much indeed. Also for Nurse Siobhan Lacey, working in Dublin. That comes in from her sister, Niamh, from Mammy Patsy, from Michael, from Deirdre, from Tommy, the dad, from Kira and Aaron in Canada that I just mentioned, and from Katrina and John. So we're very best of luck to all our nurses on the front line right across the country. And also a special request for Peggy Malone. We're here tonight for the Carlocky Kenny home care team, but Peggy is from a famous part of Kilkenny. She's in Tulliher in County Kilkenny, 89 years young, and also for her daughter, 40 years a nurse this week, still working at the University Hospital in Waterford. So that's Breeda Malone Whittle. So well done to them all in doing that. Mark Gibson is in Swords in County Dublin. Good Fingallians man. Paddy and Gillian Martin watching in Balbriggan. O'Dwyer's GA man and a great cricket man is our Paddy. Great friend of John Mooney's as well. We bowled out England a few years ago in the World Cup with Kevin O'Brien. So John is a great friend of Paddy's. Deirdre Canavan is in Minnevyog. Aoife Dowling in Carlow. From Castle Dermot. So Aoife, that's a good wishes coming in for you today. Now, Hannah Brophy. Good evening, Hannah. You're in the Fighting Cocks. We missed out on your request last week, but you're very, very welcome to the show. And thanks for all your support and telling everybody. So Hannah is out there. We say hello to Julie, Tom, and all the family and all our friends in the Fighting Cocks area of County Carlow. Liam O'Connor is in Rome. Good evening, Rome. And hello to his lovely wife, Catusia. I got it right tonight, so I did. And now for Bernard Hennessy, and I'm hoping to have Bernard next week. We had Michael last week and all his girls. Bernard is in Nace. It was his birthday last Saturday, just gone. And his sister Mary's birthday, who's the mother of David O'Neill, who sang last week, his birthday was yesterday. Now, what I'm told is Mary is 2 years older than Bernard. Mary's 37. All right. That comes from Michael and Anne in Browns Hill. So thank you very much, Michael and Anne. And for Dermot and Anita in Coolsden, they're watching in tonight. And Gavin, Mandy, and all your families, Trevor and Amanda, and all the families. And also for Noreen and John Nolan in Crawley in London as well, just up the road there from Whiteleaf and Coolsden and Croydon in that part of the world. And the Porrick and Peter in Brixton, you're very, very welcome to the programme. Indeed. Now, when you do all those type of things, you kind of lose your train of thought. I hope you're all enjoying it. Don't forget, it's for the Carlocky Kenny home care team, and the link is on the page, the link is on the stream on the bottom, and anything small would be very worthwhile for the Carlocky Kenny home care team, because there's no fundraisers or table quizzes, and they do rely a lot on charity, even though they do get a little bit of help from the authorities. But we felt that was the charity to go with tonight and for next week. So it's the Carlocky Kenny home care team, Mr. Wilson and his team down there in Kilkenny, which do great work in the palliative care area in Carlocky Kenny, and to all their nurses, we wish them well also. Mentioning Kilkenny, young lady we had last week, her niece Ruby was with her last week. Not quite sure whether she's with Tracy Millay this week, but Tracy, very popular camogie player, GA star, radio, you name it, involved in a lot of entertainment. You're very welcome back to the show, Tracy. You're in Fox Cover in County Kilkenny. Good evening.
Hi, Brendan. Good night. Delighted to be with you again on the back of your huge success of your first night's show. It was a privilege to be involved with the lovely Ruby, my little niece. Obviously, she's not with me tonight. She's after abandoning me, or in other words, she's gone very shy. But I was so delighted to be able to sing that lovely song that we loved, Never Alone, which was my dad's favourite. So, and I'd like to thank everybody for all the lovely comments that you actually sent through to myself and Ruby. We enjoyed looking at them. It was really, really lovely to get them all. So tonight I have the glad rags on. I'm after taking off the tracksuit after probably 6 weeks of living in the runners. So I'm feeling a bit alive tonight. So anybody that knows me down through the years after Camogie or Hurling matches, I'd be always willing to sing a barb song at the end of the night. And Mary Black is always on number one artist that I would love. So tonight I'm actually going to sing just a song I think that everybody knows, and it's probably very apt for the current times that we're in again. It's called No Frontiers. So sit back and enjoy. If life is a river, your heart is a boat, and just like a water baby, baby, want to float. And if life is a wild wind that blows away on high, and your heart is a million dying to find. Hey, fears and our faith, and we stack all the dead men in self-addressed graves. In your eyes, faint as the singing of a love, that somehow this black night feels warm for the spark, warm for the spark.
Thanks, Tracy.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, we just lost a little bit of a link there. But anyway, thanks, Tracy, down in Fox Cover in County Kilkenny. And don't forget, the Carlo Kilkenny Home Care Team are the beneficiaries tonight. The link is on the scroll. It's on the BenFM TV page as well, if you'd like to make a donation, no matter what size as well. Sharon O'Byrne, happy birthday tomorrow for your friend Julie in the Fighting Cox. So happy birthday to you. And just to let you know, folks, coming up in the show, we'll have Ed Byrne in a few minutes' time. We'll have up-and-coming young Carlo star Dale Bulger. Don't miss him. Unbelievable. Lorraine Nolan, we're going back to Newbridge. Martina Hannigan is doing the ironing, we're told, and she's waiting for her friend to come on air. Rihanna Jarrett, Republic of Ireland Soccer International. Rihanna will be having a few words with me later on in the programme. Matt Levy from At Boy in the County of Meath, brilliant country music star. Joe Clear in Ballochmyler. We're going to Austin, Texas again for Pat Byrne and Samantha Della Fav. And hello to all Samantha's family as well, because I know there's big Italian connections there as well, and they're all watching in tonight as well. We're going to Donegal, Mickey Johart, We Got the World Tonight. Back to Kilkenny for Davy Cashin from the Kilkenny's, world famous as well, great singing man as well. But as promised, we're going to Dublin. We had this man's brother last week, Brian Byrne, with Bristol Bears in England. But this young man has really made big waves for himself, all bar one or two little injuries a few months ago. But the break now.
And when I think of all the Codys, all the Burns and Doyles and Hickeys, these lads would die for one another. Rangers, brothers, one and all. Oh, we were dancing with the Paltrow in the shadow of a red circle, underneath the silver moonlight. We were singing until dawn. Yeah, we were dancing with the Paltrow with the Pudgeon and the Porter, dancing ginger nails and polkas until the air did moan. keeping her goalie. When at last the cup was lifted, I even saw Big Bird cry. Oh, we were dancing in the pouch room, in the shadow of a Leinster, underneath the silver moonlight. We were singing until dawn. Yeah, we were dancing in the pouch room, with the punching and the porter, dancing jigs and reels and polkas until the early morning. Here we go. Frank Foley, Michael Doyle, Gary Kelly, Gary Doyle, Edward Cody, Dermot Byrne, Richard Cody, Derek Burns, Dodging Nolan, David Feeler, Paul Cody, Eddie Burns, Owen Doyle, John Cody, Dennis Murphy, James Hickey, Brian Nolan, Willie Hickey, Dennis Rhodes, David Brennan, Jack Murphy, Richard Kelly, Ted Joyce, Hugh Paddy, Seamus Kelly, Connor Fenton, James Kelly, Seamus O'Brien, and Michael O'Grady. There's the panel, what a team, the Carlo lads that dare to dream, a band of brothers standing tall, and Lester Lynch, cannot fall. Coleman, Keely, Murray, Burn, help to keep the fires burn. Tom Bellatty leads the way to all Ireland final day. Tell everybody, Brendan.
Edward Coney has it. Edward Coney sends it across to Frank Foley. Frank, he's knocked down. Where's the ball gone? Oh God, oh God, where's that ball gone? There's a scrum on the 14-yard line, and Rangers clear their line, and have it, and Richie Coney has it up. Oh my God, I've never seen anything like that, not even in the RDS with Leinster's camp. It's all over, the Mountcats, the Rangers are the Leinster champions. I told everybody, to love this one. From Ballymurphy to Bangkok, from Rahan to Rhodesia, and from Forest to all over the world, this has been a day for Carlo Hurling.
Good man, Brennan. I'm glad you remembered all that commentary. Great to hear it. You're a legend. Hope everyone at home is staying safe and well. Last week I was joined by a very beautiful special guest, Samantha Delafave, my girlfriend. She's going to join me again, back by popular demand. Put your hands together at home. There she is.
Hi, Brendan. How are you?
Samantha's from New Jersey.
Hi, Samantha.
Isolated here at Canyon Lake, just outside Austin, Texas.
Better than being at the barrel, Pat.
Pretty impressive.
Yeah,
very
that's,
fun.
That's for all the Rangers team.
I would have passed out.
I don't know if you understood any of it. But,
no, not really.
That's for everyone back in Boris and Bob Murphy and Carlo. Hope you're all keeping well, and we're going to leave you with a John Prine song. John Prine passed away a couple of weeks ago. Big hero of mine and Samantha's, and this is one of his best ones. Thanks again, Brendan. See you all soon. How's this going? Like her eggs are running, she thinks crossing her legs is funny. She looks down her nose at money. She gets it on like an Easter bunny. She's my baby, I'm her honey. I'm never gonna let her go.
My baby, I'm his honey, never gonna let him go.
so lost, honey, we're the big dog prize. We're gonna smite our noses right off of our faces. There won't be nothing but big old hearts dancing in our eyes. In spite of ourselves, we'll end up sitting on a rainbow. Against the odds, honey, we're the big dog prize. We're gonna smite our noses right off of our faces. There won't be nothing but big old hearts dancing in our eyes. There won't be nothing but big old hearts dancing in our eyes.
In spite.
Oh, well done, Patton. Well done, Samantha.
Hey, thanks. Enjoy
Thank
the rest
you.
Of the night, everyone.
We will.
Hope you're keeping well at home and look forward to seeing you all again.
Okay,
good
well,
man,
thanks
Brendan.
A million. Thanks, Samantha. And I can tell you one thing, if he comes home at Christmas, he rings Samantha, there's going to be some session in Joyce's the Burris. If Dennis Meaney gets in there tonight, he'll be pulling the pints already. Good evening to John and all the gang there, and to Pat's mam and dad down there in Ballymurphy in County Carlow as well. And I want to pay compliments to Greg down at Hedgehog. Pat tipped him off he was going to do that song, and Greg threw in the feed of Mount Leinster Rangers. So good evening to all my friends in Mount Leinster Rangers, and to Tara Kelly and all the gang there in Ballyine and everybody. So well done, Greg, on that one as well. Thank God I didn't have to do it from the chair live. But Samantha said she didn't understand what I was talking about. I don't think anybody does. But anyway, it was a terrific day for Carlow Hurling, as I said, and we wish the lads and all our GAA pals and friends, club and county, the very best, and all our sports people, GAA soccer, everybody, you know, because everyone is tied down at the minute, as we all know. Right, apologies again. We knew there was Wi-Fi problems, and I know I don't have to keep saying it, but some people have come back to us, and thanks for that. Just in relation to the Mount Leinster Rangers thing there, Paul Cody was a great star on that team. He scored 3 points in that All-Ireland final. Last weekend, for the jersey giveaway, Paul is doing a fantastic charity thing. He's asking people to donate. He's made 25,000 raised for the Irish Cancer Society already, and you can look at it on the site or go to Paul's page on Facebook, and all sport, all support is greatly appreciated. It's a hurling jerseys giveaway for the Irish Society, organised by Paul Cody. And well done to Paul Cody from Ballymurphy. He's got 25,000 in the kitty already, and this is going into the last weekend. So well done, Paul. He's got a jersey from every county that he asked to give. So well done there, and thanks very much, Paul, and I'm glad I could give you that mention. Right, we're going from Austin, Texas, via Burris and Ballymurphy to Donegal. I did a gig with this man a few years ago. He might remember, and he mightn't. We got the world tonight. We all sang it, 2003. Hard to believe. Good evening, Mickey Joe Hart.
Hello, Brendan. It's great to be hooked up to you and part of the Ben FM show tonight. First time for me, I'm pretty sure, but not the first time to meet you. I know we met one night in Portlaoise way back. I think it was something to do with the Rose of Tralee competition.
Was, yeah.
Anyway, it's been a while. First of all, I just wanted to say hello to all friends and family in the Kilkenny, Carlow area. Have a host of relations in Carlow and up in even as far as Kildare there, and the O'Boyle clan and Des in particular up in Shelbridge there and all those people. So Uncle Dan's offsprings, that's okay to say. Anyway, great to be part of this, and thanks to you all, and thanks to, I think, Eddie Hughes is our mutual contact and friend in Kilkenny, and Brendan and Matt the Millers and Ray and them all. So we always have great crack in Kilkenny and Carlow. Never had a bad night down that way, I'll tell you. Anyway, I'll do a couple of songs for you. Wasn't sure what to sing, but I'm just trying to keep it upbeat and free and happy. And I remember, if my memory serves me correctly, that you have friends in Bryson's and Mahara Felt in a great music bar, a music venue I used to play some years back. As the man says, there's great links with fantastic music that bar has. And I thought, I'll tell you what, saying it's up in Mahara Felt, up in Mid Ulster there, it's in County Derry. So I thought I'll do a little number from a Derry band. What do you reckon? A bit of pop music from Northern Ireland.
Every time she walks down the street, another girl in
There you go, Brendan, handing it back to you again. Thanks for asking me to be part of the Ben FM show. Delighted to be part of it.
Thanks,
keep it,
Mike.
Keep it going and keep connecting with people. It's very important, as you know, at this time of crisis. All right, stay in touch. Goodbye.
Certainly
see you soon. Bye-bye.
Thanks, Michael. There's Mickey Jawhart there in the county of Donegal. And I want to thank my good friend Eddie Hughes in Kilkenny. Eddie, of course, works in KCLR and he's the DJ and Matt and Miller's, and we do several gigs across the country over the years. Well, Eddie is the contact for Mickey there. He said, I'll get you heart, and he got him heart. But when it's for the Carlow Kilkenny Homecare team, he will be back, as he said, to Matt and Miller's, and be back in Carlow when all the pubs open, and we hope that won't be too far away. So once again, thanks to Mickey Joe. And good to know that he... Kevin mentioned the Des O'Boyle up in Selbridge there, and all the O'Boyles, his cousins here in Carlow. So there you are, there's connections everywhere. So thanks to Mickey Joe Hart for doing that for us. Now, over the last 2 weeks, there's one person that I really wanted on this show. Now, I deliberately didn't ask because Greg and I had plans that we might pose a bit of a surprise to somebody out there, do it a little bit like Gogglebox or Anton Deck, whatever you like to say. But during the week, we had a chat on the phone and Greg slipped a camera to this man's fiance, wiped down, COVID clean, and the camera is in his house. So we are hopefully going to have him on the show tonight. And I'm just getting word on my ear. He's watching the show. He hasn't a clue who he is, but Paul Dargan, are you there in Greg Cullen, Paul? Oh, there's a shock. He caught me out several times before. So there he is.
Ah, Brendan.
How are you, Paul? How is everything on the west bank of the River Barrow? Leash County Board PRO with the GAA. Dancer extraordinaire who has caught me out. You've caught me out many times before. Now I got you, right? I got you. How are you, Paul?
I was doing all right now, Brendan, until I sat down to watch the programme, and great programme, but you're kind of ending with me, which isn't the plan or was discussed or anything. I've got you dancing a few times and I've put you in a few situations, but this is one now where you've got me now, I have to say. It's a Jeremy Beadle stroke Anton Deck, you've got me. And it's not easy to catch me out. So fair play to yourself and Greg now with that one. You've... What can I say?
Now, Paul, what I don't want you to do is I don't want you to give out to Joan, your fiancé. It was Greg's idea, my idea, as we both know you. And we both know... You're a tremendous entertainer. You've danced all over the world. You've even danced on the radio. I've seen you dance in Cambodia. You've danced all over Asia, America, the UK, Ireland. I've seen you win in a talent competition dancing on a pool table. That was the official stage on the night. So I know we've caught you by surprise, but we are hoping, and everybody that knows you are hoping, and all the weddings that you've danced with, that you'll do a dance for us tonight. Will you do one for us?
I'll go get the shoes.
I'm delighted to catch him out because I was at a gig in Dublin one night and I was standing minding my own business, and the next thing one of the female dancers, Jenny Brady, if you're watching, came down and grabbed me, and with 3 pints in, I'd been spun around the floor. It wasn't pretty, so I waited 16, 17 years to get him back. So there we are. So did Greg, because he caught out Greg before as well. So we'll be back to Paul in a few minutes. Hopefully he gets ready to do the dance and we link back up. We've no more Wi-Fi problems, but we're going to Kilkenny our final visit to Kilkenny tonight. Don't forget, this gig is for the Carlow Kilkenny Home Care Team, as will next Monday night show be as well. So if you want to make a donation, the link is underneath. And because we got a few problems here, we got a dig out from a few family members who've put the link back up there. So if you put it up again, just to remind people, they can donate during the week as well on next Monday night show, and then we'll seal it off there as well. So we're going back to Kilkenny, a man with strong Carlow connections, but he's famous across the world, across Europe. He plays with the Kilkennys, and I'm delighted to have him on our show tonight. Good evening, Davy Cashin.
Thank you, Brendan, and thank you for having me on the show. Pleasure and honour to be here. Good evening, everybody. Hope you're all staying safe and well. Shout out to anybody in Carlow, Kilkenny, or anywhere around the world. Modern technology is great. We can perform music now and broadcast it to the whole planet. And it's been about 6 weeks since I've been on stage performing live. So I'm missing the music, but I'm happy to be able to do this tonight for everybody. Got the old waistcoat out, hasn't been out in a while, so any excuse to dress up, I'm going to take it now. Brendan, you're always looking sharp and dapper. Last time I saw you was in Kilkenny. Who's your tailor, by the way? Plenty of tailors down in Carlow. Saw you in Kilkenny at the homecoming, and we were singing songs and having the laugh, as we always do. So we hope to do that again when all this craziness and madness is over. Plenty of GAA matches coming up. I don't know if they'll take place this year, but we'll look forward to it whenever they do come back. So I was thinking about what song I might perform this evening. And you don't want to sing a song just for the sake of singing a song. So it's got to mean something. And I wanted to try and tie it in with what's going on at the minute. 2020, lockdown. People can't work. Unprecedented times, scary times. We don't know what's ahead of us, but we're a resilient nation. We're a hardy bunch. We find a way through the tough times, wars, famines, diseases. We've come through it in the past, over the decades and over the centuries. And if you turn your mind back to 1913, over 100 years ago, well over 100 years ago, before the 1916 rising, in Dublin city centre, they had the 1913 lockout. And that's where a group of wealthy businessmen came together to lock out the workers who tried to form a union under James Larkin for better working conditions. They shut them out, wouldn't let them come to work for 6 months. No wages. Scary times, didn't know how to put bread on the table, feed the family, look after the kids. Similar times today, scary times, we don't know what's gonna happen, but we will get through it, I'm confident of that. History. The Irish history has told a story, and there's a pattern there, and we will get through it in the future. And we're going to stick together, and we're going to sing this song together, because the lyrics in this song ring true today, and there's a significance here. If you take every word in this chorus, it can be related back to 1913 and what we're going through today. We're on the one road, we're sharing the one load, we're on the road to God knows where. We're on the one road, it may be the wrong road, but we're together now, who cares? Northmen, Southmen, comrades all, Dublin, Belfast, Cork and Donegal, we're on the one road, swinging along, singing a soldier's song. Let's sing it, everybody. We're on the one road, sharing the one load, we're on the road to God knows where. We're on the one road, it may be the wrong road, but we're together now, who cares? Northmen, Southmen, comrades all, Dublin, Belfast, Cork and Donegal, we're on the one road, swinging along, singing a soldier's song. Although we've had our troubles now and then, now is the time to make them up again. Sure aren't we all Irish anyhow? Now is the time we're set together now. We're on the one road, sharing the one load. We're on the road to God knows where. We're on the one road, it may be the wrong road, but we're together now, who cares? Northmen, Southmen, comrades all, Dublin, Belfast, Cork and Donegal. We're on the one road, singing along, singing a soldier's song. Tinker, tailor, every mother's son, butcher, baker, shoulder, and he's gone. Rich man, poor man, every man in line,
all together just like our lifetime. We're on the one road, sharing the one load. We're on the road to God knows where. We're on the one road, it may be the wrong road, but we're together now, who cares? North and south men, comrades all, Dublin, Belfast, Cork and Donegal. We're on the one road, swinging along, singing a soldier's song. Night is darkest just before the dawn, from the Ascension Ireland is reborn. Soon we'll all, united Irish men, make our land a nation once again. We're on the one road, sharing the one load. We're on the road to God knows where. We're on the one road, it may be the wrong road, but we're together now, who cares? North men, south men, comrades all, Dublin, Belfast, Cork and Donegal. We're on the one road, swinging along, singing a soldier song. We're on the one road, keep it going, lads. Talk to you soon, Brendan. Thank you very much.
Thanks very much, David. You're very welcome. And I know there's a lot of you out there saying, now you know that chap. Yes, the late Mr. and Mrs. Cashin from the Pollerton Road with his granny and granddad, and Adrian Cashin in Kilkenny, Alan and Peter's brother down there, is that young man's father. Tremendous musical family. He sings all over the world, Davy, and we're delighted that he joined us tonight as well. I have to thank Eddie Hughes as well, because I had Davy's number a few years ago. Eddie gave it to me. We contacted him. He says, why not, for the Carlow Kilkenny home care team. Here we are. Don't forget, folks, this programme will be on the BenFM TV page all week. So if you missed anything due to the Wi-Fi being down, we tracked it and we had it. It's just a stream we lost. It's a stream we lost, and we have everybody. So you will be able to look back at it in full. And thank you very much for your kind support and the great comments that's coming in as well. Just a happy birthday to John Owens in Highfield. John, I believe, is 40 this week. So happy birthday, John, in regards to all your family there as well. Your sister, Aisling, was in touch with us earlier on. I'm sorry I didn't get to all the scrolling on the thing, because I lost it on the iPad. And then there was people texting me to say, you're down. Do you know you're down? And when 400 people start texting you, it got rattled. We got rattled a small bit. But anyway, we're up and running, thanks to Davy. Don't forget the link. The Carlow Kilkenny Home Care team are the beneficiaries tonight of this concert, as they will be for our final concert next Monday, the bank holiday weekend. We'll be starting at 8 o'clock as well. And I know we were to be 2 hours tonight, but we ran over time because we lost 15 to 20 minutes earlier on with Wi-Fi problems. But anyway, everyone's enjoying it. The feedback is great. Thank you very much for that. And hello to John Curley McElwain up there in County Antrim. I seen a lovely comment coming in from John when Tracy was singing earlier on. John is the press photographer at Nolan Park and Netwatch Cullen Park and Croke Park, and he does the Saffron Gale up there for all GA supporters in County Antrim. So good evening, Antrim, and good evening, Tom, Patsy, Chris, and all the gang up there as well. Right, mentioning Kilkenny, this fellow works in Kilkenny, sign and design. He does a great job too. He's made lots of labels for COVID and does all the stuff for people across Carlow, Kilkenny and beyond. That's Paul Dargan, who we caught by surprise. Now we're going back to Greg Cullen. He should be off the couch and he should be ready to dance. See you there, Paul.
Tonight, Brendan, one for the road. I'm gonna give you the star of the dance at home.
There he is. Come on, Flatley. Can't hear me. Paul Dargan, there he is. Well, he was a good sport. He could have switched off the camera. He didn't. And thanks very much to Joan as well, a great Wexford woman there as well. Listen, that is our final act of the night. You can stay donating a few bob if you want to the Carlow Kilkenny Home Care team. Thanks to all the people who have donated so far tonight. And I want to say a big thank you to Greg Meinhardt and Hedgehog Productions. He got us back on the road with the Wi-Fi down more or less nationwide, we're hearing now. So sorry for the slight interruption. It rattled me a bit and might as well be honest. But anyway, we got it there. People seem to be happy. So at the start of the show, we had Trish Hutton, Claire Dunn and Yvonne Bolton. Thank you very much. John Kelly was in Ballin. He sang Follow Me Up to Carlo. Martina and Brendan Wren were down in County Roscommon. Padraig Amond was our first interview tonight from Newport in Wales. Thanks to Padraig. To Paul Hennessy in Longford. To Tomás Jackman in Kilkenny. Well done, Tomás. And continued success on your recovery from COVID. And you're absolutely flying it. And regards to your mother-in-law, Mamie, there in Castlecomer Hospital as well. Louise Delaney and Carlo. Thank you very much, Louise. You're outstanding over the last 2 weeks. Davy Russell, Grand National and Cheltenham Gold Cup winning jockey. Thanks to Davy. To Dale Hennessy and Pat O'Gorman. Strat is like a divil. The internet is still down out in Strat's Place. I told you to buy a house in the town, Strat. But anyway, Liam Joubert in Cape Town. Thank you very much, Liam. The magic man. He was absolutely outstanding. Write down his name. Remember where you seen him first. On the Ben FM show, not the Late Late Show, the Ben FM show. That's where you're seeing Liam Joubert. So thank you, South Africa. Tracy Malay, my good friend in Kilkenny. Thank you, Tracy, doing her Mary Black number tonight. Very good. And thank you very much, Tracy. A girl who also does lots of work for the home care team and lots of charities across Kilkenny as well. Ed Byrne of Leinster. That's when we dropped the time, but we'll have that in full for you if you look back tomorrow or later on tonight on the BenFM TV page, and I'll share it as well. To Dale Bulger, up and coming star in Carlo down there on Granby Row in College Gardens. Thank you very much, Dale. You did a brilliant job for us tonight. Lorraine Nolan in Newbridge never lets me down. Thank you very much, Lorraine, and happy birthday again. To Rihanna Jarrett in Wexford, Republic of Ireland, now the soccer move to 2022. Keep an eye out for Rihanna, outstanding player. Matt Levy in County Meath, thanks, Matt. Best of luck with the new album. Joe Clear in Ballochmyler. Joe came in like a light, out like a light, even though he sang in the dark. So well done, Joe. You played an absolute blinder. World-class performance from Joe. Pat and Samantha Delafav brought back memories, Mount Leinster Rangers, Dancing in Kilcoltrum, and a brilliant song that I know Michael Hennessy liked. And well done, Mike, and your team effort last week with us as well. So thank you very much, Samantha Delafav, and all your family looking in the States, and to Pat and all his family looking in County Carlow. Mickey Joe Hart, what more can I say? The man in County Donegal. We got the world tonight. We gave you a good show tonight. Thank you, Mickey. Thanks to Eddie Hughes in Kilkenny for sorting out that. Davy Cashin wrapping it up there with the music for us tonight down there in Kilkenny. Very well done, Davy, and we really appreciate you giving your time, and the best of luck when you go back touring Europe as well, and we look forward to seeing you in concert. And Paul Dargan, our good friend, great man, he's responsible for a bit of this memorabilia behind us here as well, and thanks to Paul as well. So they're all our entertainers tonight and our interviews. We will be back next Monday night with a few more surprises, a few more great guests. Just one more time, a big thank you to Greg Meinhardt and his family. He puts a few hours into organising this. There is a bit of work involved, but as I've said at the outset, we're both out of work television-wise, and we pass the time by stringing together the people, ringing them on the night, getting them on the show, and keeping you, the people who have to stay at home, a bit of entertainment. That's all we're trying to do. No one is benefiting anyway out of this. All the artists have given their time for free. So have we. But if you have a spare few bob or a few quid, the Carlo Kilkenny Home Care team is the beneficiary tonight for the concert, as they will be throughout the week with the link left on the page, and next Monday night for our final show on Bank Holiday Monday. So we'll see you back here next Monday at 8 o'clock. Thanks to Tamsin Tucker and Ellie Kelly for all their support in the stage design here tonight, and to Greg and all the team at Hedgehog Productions. Until next Monday night, Garamina Mogwiv. Talk to you then. Bye-bye for now, and thanks for being great support again tonight. Bye-bye.